I mean, Joel Embiid completely changes the 76ers defense from being terrible to being phenomenal. I mean, look at him here on drop coverage right here. Look at how he's able to stay attached to Bam Adebayo. Then the second he, so that lob is not going to be there. Then the second he needs to come contest on Duncan Robinson, he's there for that. Now Jimmy Butler's going to beat Kyle Lowry on a pump and go drive. We're going to help out on that. There's going to be nothing there. Swing it to Bam Adebayo. Look at him quickly with one stride, get out and guard. I mean, it's unbelievable. Joel Embiid is like having two defenders on the floor. This is off an offensive rebound. 76ers are late getting back. So Embiid is going to, first of all, guard Nikola Jovic here, so that's not a drop-off pass. And then watch him quickly move out to Duncan Robinson on this corner three. I mean, look at how much ground he covers here. One step. Look at that. Look at how that space closes. Clear contest, nothing. I mean, you just don't have this with Paul Reed. Again, drop coverage, like he is the 76ers pick-and-roll defense because he's going to stay attached to Bam. There's no backside help here. So he's going to stay attached to Bam Adebayo because he knows he can come out to contest Terry Rozier whenever he needs to. So let's wipe out that lob from happening or that pocket pass from happening. Then we can, once he gets downhill, we'll come back over and help on the ball. Kyle Lowry's there as well. No lob, nothing. Just a human eraser defensively. Look at Tyrese Maxey. This is terrible defense. He's going to lean towards the screen early. But Joel Embiid covered. And this is Terry Rozier getting downhill. And Joel Embiid just covers so much space. So even as Maxey gets blown by, Joel Embiid is able to get right back in the play, clean up the mistake, out of bounds, Sixers ball. I mean, it's the 76ers defense legitimately goes from being bottom 15 to top 10 with Joel Embiid. I mean, he is pick and roll defense here. And it's the ground he covers. Like, he's guarding the ball right here on Nicholas Batum's not getting over the screen, but he's going to guard the ball, first of all, get the dribble picked up, and look at, I mean, this, for Paul Reed, for anybody else, this is Bam Adebayo catching this on the run for two. But Embiid's able to immediately come back in the play, force this shot outside the paint, and contest. This is, again, terrible defense by the 76ers right here, but Joel Embiid can play free safety because of the amount of ground he can cover. Look, Tyrese Maxey switches over the top of the screen. It doesn't matter. Joel Embiid's in help in the paint. Now they swing it back out to Bam Adebayo. Joel Embiid's really not ready to guard right here, and Bam Adebayo's going to lower his shoulder into Embiid. If this is anyone else, they're flying backwards with Embiid, his size, his strength. Look at him. Try and lower his shoulder, still able to contest, nothing. This is just ridiculous right here. I mean, Joel Embiid is going to literally bite on a pump fake, and Jimmy Butler's going to get him in the air. But again, the strength to be able to pin Jimmy Butler right here, he just left his feet. The strength to keep Jimmy, once he's got him pinned to the sideline, there's no place for Jimmy Butler to go. He's not going to outwork Joel Embiid. Now, I don't know what KJ Martin's doing here, why he's helping, so you're going to give up an open three. But I mean, look at that one-on-one defense. That's after you just left your feet on a pump fake. There's almost no one that can do that. You still get a miss. This is just unbelievable right here. First off, Joel Embiid again is going to bite on a pump fake, but it doesn't matter. Once he's got you pinned to that out of bounds line right there, he's just bigger and stronger than you. So Jacquez should have him beat right here, but it's not going to let him pin him to the sideline right here. Now you're going to see Jimmy Butler beat his man backdoor on a cut. So Joel Embiid goes from guarding the ball then to taking Jimmy Butler on the cut right here, and they're not getting anything. I mean, now they just have Joel Embiid parked in the paint right here playing a one-man zone. Like, Jimmy Butler's going to ISO on Nicholas Batum, and he's going to have him beat. But Joel Embiid, they're going to ignore Haywood Highsmith right here, and Joel Embiid's going to sit in the paint right here. So Batum's beat, it doesn't matter. You got a one-man zone going on right here, and Jimmy Butler, there's no chance he can take this shot, and then you end up with that. Almost nobody can get away with this. Joel Embiid is just going to matriculate into the charge circle right here, not even paying attention to Haywood Highsmith. He's going to come over and double. And look at Jacquez seeing Embiid waiting right here. So Highsmith does a great job cutting, but it just doesn't matter. Joel Embiid has a late reaction, but again, the size, the length, there's no way you're going up for two right here. Then again, like, no place to go there. Kick it back out, restart. All of these clips here before Joel Embiid was injured are points for the Heat. But again, look at this. Look at him double the baseline right here, first of all. Look at no place for Jimmy Butler to turn now. Then Bam Adebayo cuts to the middle of the floor. Look at how many, one stride he gets over and contests this little mid-range floater. This is just absurd right here. Jimmy Butler, Joel Embiid is late to double right here. Jimmy Butler's going to beat him to the block. But again, I mean, Joel Embiid's size and strength. I mean, Jimmy Butler's finishing through just about anyone here. He's beat him. He's inside the block right now. But look at the size, the strength, verticality, nothing. Joel Embiid can guard pretty much 1 through 5 right here because he can play so far off. Look at him guard Jimmy Butler right here. He can play. Look at how far off. He's 4 steps off. But again, when Jimmy Butler pulls up here, look at how much ground he's going to cover in an instant. in an instant, he's going to go from being four steps off to right in your face contesting. Again, Tyrese Maxey makes a mistake here defensively, but look at Joel Embiid. He can play free safety. He's in the paint. He's a one-man defense. Jimmy Butler's again. Tyrese Maxey switches over the top of the screen again, but Jimmy Butler's not going to be able to get all the way down low and seal because you got Joel Embiid standing and waiting. So now Jimmy Butler's got to post up outside the paint right here because Joel Embiid's standing and lurking. And now look at, you're not able to get this pass down there, and you end up with a contested nothing. I mean, there's almost nobody in the NBA that when Bam Adebayo, first of all, look at him slide his feet, and then when Bam Adebayo turns his shoulder into him, look who's pushing who back. I mean, usually defenders are flying backwards. Look when Adebayo lowers his shoulder into Embiid. Look who's flying the other way. That'd be Adebayo flying outside the paint. So that's an unbelievable. Then Jovic beats his man back door. We're going to come over and contest that too. And again, they got him ISO. Jimmy Butler's ISOing Joel Embiid on the perimeter. I mean, it's just one-on-one right here. And Joel Embiid, again, can play way off right here. Jimmy Butler has the middle of the floor if he wants it, but he knows he cannot get physical with Embiid. He's going to move him backwards. So we're going to play off Jimmy Butler. If the drive happens, we're going to be there. And then with one small stride, we can come up and then contest. This is ridiculous. This is the most insane clip of Joel Embiid you will see playing defense. He's on the weak side wing here. Kelly Oubre is going to fall right here. Look at Joel Embiid go from the weak side wing all the way up to the three-point line to get a contest on that. That's insanity. Watch Joel Embiid guards about five different actions right here. First of all, on the pick and roll, look at him in drop coverage right here. No place for Terry Rozier to go. He can easily recover to Adebayo. Then they're going to try and run another ball screen right here. Again, look at Joel Embiid up the line. There's no place. If Terry Rozier gets downhill, Joel Embiid's right there. And then he can recover. Now watch, they're going to ISO Jimmy Butler on Kyle Lowry right here. Joel Embiid's going to come over and double. Nothing for Jimmy Butler. Then Bam Adebayo flashes to the paint. Joel Embiid can go quickly from doubling to recovering, and it's just insane.